Mrs. Stratford, you have a visitor.
Surprise! Hey, sis! I was missing you and couldn't wait a single day longer to see you.
Marianne, what a nice surprise. I see you're a blonde now.
Yeah, we're not quite identical anymore. This party is going to be so exciting, don't you think, Abigail?
Yes, Miss Marianne. It's been so long since we've had a party in this house. After you've finished your preparations, ring for me, and I'll send Mr. Stratford.
Abigail is such a sweetheart. Anyway, I didn't show up early for nothing. Let me help you. Abigail mentioned you still need to take care of seating arrangements, decorating, and your own costume. Why don't I help you pick out decorations? Here are the ones I picked. Combine them how you like. Are you sure? Done. What do you want to do next? Looks like everyone is settled. Should we take care of the menu now? Abigail told me the Stratfords used to host parties like this all the time.
That was before, when Elliot's first wife, Caroline, was still alive. He had a really hard time after she died. This party is a huge step for him.
I'm glad you two found each other. Now, on to the matter of your costume. There are a few dresses that would work for Cleopatra. Bring them on out! That looks great on you. Is that the one you want to wear to the party? Good choice. I can't wait to show you my costume, too. Done. Elliot will be here in no time. We just need to ring that bell.
Hello, you two. Looking forward to the party, Marianne?
I can't wait!
Darling, would you hand me the seating chart and the decorations?
Sure thing. Here they are.
I'll take care of that, and leave you two to catch up.
See you soon! I'm glad everyone is having fun. Abigail really outdid herself. Too bad our butler, Mr. Roberts, couldn't be here. Even helped Elliot pick out his Caesar costume. But I'm sure he's enjoying his vacation. I finally had the pleasure of meeting Franklin. Coming back to this house after his sister's death must have been hard. But it seems like he's enjoying himself. He seems very proud of his Dracula costume. And Joseph. It's been years since I last saw him. Lancelot suits him as a costume, too. He's the reason Elliot and I met. I was just starting to relax when Marianne took me outside for a walk. Knowing her, she's cooking up some silly idea, just like her idea to dress up as Marie Antoinette. I hope you have a good reason for dragging me away from my own party.
Sorry, sis. I had the craziest idea, and I just couldn't wait to share it with you! Remember when we used to switch places when we were little? Let's do it right now! We can trade costumes and mess with the guests a little!
I don't know, Marianne. I mean, we could.
Great! Meet me in the bathroom and make sure no one sees you!
Oh, wait! I didn't say... Oh, fine. For old time's sake.
Sorry, the reflection startled me. Never mind. My eyes must have been playing tricks on me. Would you mind passing me the dustpan? We can't have broken glass lying around at a party.
Sure thing, Abigail.
Thank you. I'll have this cleaned up in no time.
This is going to be so much fun! They'll never know! I'll be out right behind you. I just want to touch up my makeup.
Don't fool me. I see what you're up to.
It feels so strange being here again. After all these years, it brings back a lot of memories.
Hey, Marie Antoinette, the food smells delicious, but it looks very scary. What would you suggest as tasty? Why is all that steam coming out? We should see what's going on in there.
Marianne, are you okay? What's going on in there? She's not answering. Darling, try and find the spare key. We'll try and see if we can break through the door.
So, Regina, we can laugh at that prank later, but in the meantime, I see some keys in that cupboard. Those keys are all jumbled up. You'll need to put them in order before you can find the right key. That key looks like it has a water drop. That should do the trick. Hey, look at what I just found.
I think she's in here. I can barely see anything.
I can help you get rid of the steam by turning off the hot water that passes through the boiler room in the backyard. I'll need your help, so follow me.
Joseph and I will look for Marianne. Follow me. We can start as soon as we replace the missing gauge. Adjust the pressure on your side, and I'll get the dusty one. Thank you.
That should do it. Go check the bathroom now.
Regina! Help me! You saved my life. But what's going on? The scarecrow came to life. I'm not feeling very well. My bag. There should be some emergency medical supplies in there.
What do you want from me? Where's Marianne and everyone else?
Regina? Is this a prank? I saw Caroline's ghost. How can that be?
I saw her too. A masked maniac is wandering the house. She helped me get away. But Mr. Roberts wasn't so lucky.
What on earth? That attacker could be anywhere. We have to move. If I understood Elliot correctly, Roberts was a great hunter, right? Maybe there's some kind of weapon in his room. Would you help me unlock it? No. First Mr. Roberts, and now Abigail. What kind of a monster would do something like this? We can't just stand here unarmed and wait for the killer to strike again. We have to find something to protect ourselves. I'm afraid there's nothing we can do for her. We must hurry and find the others. There! That looks like a rifle case to me.
Thank you.
Regina, get out! I'll stop him. You get the rifle. Should do it. Regina, go upstairs quickly. I'll be right behind you. He's still after us. There's no way to lock this passage, so I'll stand guard. You find the others. I tried to stop him, but he was too fast. Not even the bullet could slow him down. You should find a safe place to hide. It's too late for me.
Regina, thank goodness you're all right. I know about Abigail and Mr. Roberts. And now Joseph. Come with me to the library. It's not safe here.
Elliot, something terrible is happening. At first, I thought my mind was playing tricks on me. There's a masked murderer in our home. Where have you been?
I was trying to find Marianne. Regina, I've been seeing Caroline's ghost. I don't know if she has anything to do with all of this.
Anybody in there? Let me in.
It's Franklin. I need to make sure the other passage is properly blocked. You let him in.
Are you okay? I heard a gunshot. Something strange is going on in this house, and it's your fault, Elliot. Have you ever told Regina what you did to my sister? I'll show her everything. Come with me.
I don't know what you're talking about. You're just trying to put the blame on me. Go with him, Regina. I've got nothing to hide.
We need to get through this door. It's a bit overgrown, but I don't think it'll be too hard to open. There, behind that wall, was mine and Caroline's room when we were kids. We could smash through it with those axes and get inside. He must be hiding something. Why else would he build that wall?
I tried to convince him, but he just wouldn't listen. He gave up so easily and let her die. This is what he sent me. Do you believe me now? We need to show this to him.
It's not what it looks like. It was her choice to end the treatment and spend her last days with the people she loved. The only way to find out the truth is to go to my office and find Caroline's diary. Here.
Thank you.
Let's search the office.
Thank you.
knew he was behind this from the start. Let's see what he has to say. There's some pretty solid evidence against him. How will you defend yourself now, Elliot? Regina, show him what we found.
Someone must have planted the mask there and taken Caroline's diary. I would never do such a thing.
Do you really think we can believe you after everything we found?
We tried everything to find the right medical treatment, but she was getting worse by the minute. Caroline wanted to end the suffering and die in peace. I honored her last wish.
Enough lies!
I want to believe you. I really do. But the letters, the mask...
I know how this looks, but... Franklin, is that blood on your arm?
It's nothing, just a scratch.
That doesn't look like a scratch to me. That's a bullet wound! It was you all along!
Yes, it was me this whole time. And you won't stop me now. Now, drink this. I have some unfinished business to attend to. Excuse us.
Regina, you made it. Franklin took Elliot to my crypt. I'll help you get there. Marianne is lost in the underground tunnels, but she's okay. We'll send her for you on the way. Take my portrait and go to the first floor bathroom. It's right beneath this room. There's a secret passage we need to open to get to them. Hurry! No matter where you go, I'll be by your side from now on. Turn on both faucets in the sink and tub. Check the brick, mark the nest. There used to be a map for these tunnels. I don't know the way by heart, but surely I can help. Or would you prefer to figure it out on your own?
You are.
Oh, Regina, I'm so happy to see you. Help me get out of here. There's a strange lock on both sides of this door. The one on your side looks broken, and mine is missing a tile. See if you can find it.
Is behind that gate. You'll have to repair this bridge to get to it, but first help your sister. Thank you.
Here it is. We could start working on that lock now. We did it! I saw Franklin dragging Elliot away.
I know where they are! Take this map and go back to the house. Try to call for help, and I'll go help Elliot.
Franklin, this has to stop. It doesn't have to be this way.
It's too late. You have to pay for what you did to my sister.
Don't get any closer. I'll do it. I swear.
Franklin, let me go. Why are you doing this? It was my decision to stop medical treatment. And let him go, or I'll force you to. Life is so precious, and I wish for long ones for both of you. Goodbye.